Yes?
Judge Thurgood Marshall in New York on 90.
I see. Okay. Take this, will you?
Yes, sir.
Hello?
Yes, sir.
Judge, how are you?
Fine, sir.
I have a rather big problem that I want to talk to you about.
Right.
I want you to give it some real thought, because it's something that I have thought about for weeks, and I think we can't think of how it affects us personally. We've got to think about the world and our country and our government and then ourselves way down at the bottom of the list. I want you to be my Solicitor General.
Wow.
Now, you lose a lot. Lose security, and you lose the freedom that you like, and you lose the philosophizing that you can do, and I'm familiar with all those things. You won't lose any, and I want you to do it for two or three reasons. One, I want the top lawyer in the United States represent me before the Supreme Court. Be a Negro, and be a damn good lawyer that's done it before. So you have those peculiar qualifications. Number two, I think it will do a lot for our image abroad and at home too. That this is the man that the whole government has to look to decide whether it prosecutes a case or whether it goes up with a case or whether it doesn't, and so on and so forth. Number three, I want you to have the experience and be in the picture. I'm not discussing anything else, and I don't want to make any other commitments. I don't want to imply or bribe or mislead you. But I want you to have the training and experience of being there day after day for the next few weeks anyway, maybe the next few months if you could do it. Now, I've talked to Ramsey Clark, whose father is on the Supreme Court, and both of them have a high regard for you. I've talked to Attorney General, Nick Katzenbach. I've talked to you. Now, I haven't talked to anybody else. I don't want to talk to anybody else. Nobody will ever know I talked to you. If you decide that you can do it, I think you ought to do it for the people of the world. I just think it will be... You've got a great job, you've got lots of security, but I don't think you'll lose any of this. And after you do it a while, if there's not something better, which I would hope there would be, that you would be more amenable to, there'll be security for you, because I'm going to be here for quite a while. But I want to do this job that Lincoln started, and I want to do it the right way. Yes, sir. Yes, you can have all the time you want. And you think it over, and you evaluate it. And this is a non-political job. It just determines what goes before that court, and then you present it, at least all you want to, and then have other people. Archie Cox will be going back to Harvard. He could stay. I could ask him to stay. But I want this man to... I think you can see what I'm looking at, and I want to be the first president that really goes all the way. But I don't want anybody to be able to clip me from behind. I want to do it on merit. I want to do it without regard to politics. I want to do it without any regard to votes, because I don't want any votes. I'm not looking for votes. I've had the votes. I had all the votes when I needed them. I had 15 million, and all I want to do is serve my term and do it well. But I also want to do something else. I want to leave my mark, and I want to see that the justice is done. And you can be a symbol there that you can't ever be where you are. Well, it's got to be. And it's got to be in you. any day or two you can come down, why, you just get on the plane and come down here and let my people know. Just call Jack Valenti here at the White House, and we'll make the appropriate arrangements. Well, I expect to be better Monday or Tuesday. I'm going to be home on Friday. I'm going home Friday afternoon. I'll be here this Wednesday. I'll be here Thursday and Friday, but I'll leave after lunch. Then I'll be there until probably Monday afternoon. I'll be back here Tuesday. What about Tuesday? We'll just, you just forget this, and let me talk to you about it in detail, and we'll work it out. And you don't know, I've thought about it for weeks, and well, you can, because you live such a life, and they've gone over you with a fine tooth comb, and they could never. They could never use anything about you to thwart us, and we're on our way now.
Wonderful.
And we're going to move.
Right. Well,
all right. That'll be fine. You have any idea what time you'd like to make it?
Anytime, sir.
What about 11 o'clock in the morning?
11 o'clock.
Thank you.
Thank you.